Lecture, we will derive expression for the force which is acting on the charged conductor because of the charge on its surface. Let us take a conductor with plus sigma charge being on its surface. This is the charge on its surface. I have shown it there, and let me show it like this. So what is the force acting on this surface because of this charge? We know that because of this charge there is an electric field En, and what is the value of that electric field? For that we should know that for a conducting thick conducting material, if you make the Gauss law application, we know that electric field inside is zero. The electric field outside is equal to sigma upon E0, and in case of sheet having positive charge, if we draw the Gauss surface, electric field is in on the both the sides, and E is equal to sigma upon twice E0. I am not deriving it here because a separate lecture is already there on that. So because of the conductor, this is the electric field, and because of the sheet, this is the electric field. Now we know this electric field En, what we call is En is sigma upon E0. Now let us take a small part out of this conductor and draw it like this. This part will also have charge density sigma, and this we are taking like a thin sheet. We have taken, means we have broken the conductor, and this is like a thin sheet. Now this sheet will produce electric field on both the sides, which is equal to, let me write it as E dash is sigma upon twice E0. Sigma upon twice E0. This sheet is experiencing an electric field because of the remaining part of the conductor. This is producing some electric field, and let it be like this. This is E1, is the electric field which is because of the conductor, the remaining part, and let it be in this direction. We know that inside the conductor the electric field has to be zero, means if this is sigma upon twice E0, this has to be upwards, and sigma upon twice E0 upwards. So this gives us E equal to zero inside the conductor, which is okay. It means value of E1 is sigma upon twice E0. This E1 is acting on this conductor, having plus sigma charge, having delta S as the surface, is experiencing an electric field equal to this. Don't take that, because it has to experience the electric field excluding its own part, and which is equal to sigma upon twice E0. What is the force due to this electric field? We will take force positive in this direction, and F would be equal to charge is sigma ds times the electric field, which is sigma upon twice E0, which is equal to sigma square delta S upon twice E0, is the value of force. Now we can replace sigma in terms of the En. En is because of the whole conductor. Because of the whole conductor, that is the electric field, which is sigma upon E0. So sigma is E0 En. Place the value here, you get E0 upon 2 En square into delta S is F you divide F by ds, you get force per unit area, which is like a pressure, is equal to E0 E n square upon 2. This is square, it means it is always positive, so it is always greater than 0, and we have taken positive as upwards, so it means that the force net in such a manner that it will try to stretch it. So it is a stretching effect the conductor gets because of the charge on itself.